What's up, YouTube? Serenity Zinmare here, along with
Death109F.
Welcome back to Serenity's Death. Right now, you can't tell, but where is it? I'm losing it. Death is flying a kite, and up. I've lost it.
up.
Oh, there it is. Yep.
Death. Yes, it is the little kid's kite.
Yes. But we finally got some wind. Oh, it lost altitude then. Whoops.
Fetch.
And I'm the fetcher. He's already got stuck on one thing one time. As long as I don't step on the string. Yeah. Yeah, as you can see, Spider-Man kite. There's not that much of a wind flow. Lost the wind. No, wait, there it went. There we go. This is why it's always better to find a field. I know, that's where I said go the first time.
What time is it?
Hold on. I think, yeah, you've completely lost the wind by now. Hold on. Time check. 6:39. Okay, never mind, we got a little bit of a wind back. There we go. Got it back in the air. For now.
Nope.
Really? Yeah, because that power line. Well, hey guys, can you send us a kite for Death? Nah, just kidding. Unless you actually want to, then you can donate a kite. If y'all would be willing to actually donate a kite, we'll actually give you a P.O. box address or something where you can send it. Maybe. But only if you guys are serious. Are you giving up on it, Death?
Nope. Never give up. Never surrender.
I will not be silenced! Ow! Ow, rope burn! Ow, rope burn! Ow! You can see where it rope burned too. Here we go.
Oh God, I'm a mess.
That's what the wind does to you. We're both windblown here.
Yep, nope. Dragging it.
All right. Serenity to the rescue. Spider-Man's in trouble. He needs some rescuing. Really? Dang kite don't want to fly. You don't have that much wind. Little bit. He's working on it. He's working on it. Oh, of course, the sucky thing about kites is as soon as you get it high enough, and then the wind dies. Also, a question for viewers. What is the best kite experience you've had, and what is the worst kite experience you've had?
Yeah, because honestly, right now, this is actually basically my worst. I've had a kite that was maybe half this size fly, whatever the words are that I need to come out of my mouth.
By the way, sorry about the glare behind us, guys. Oh, that heavenly glare. On a demon.
What?
What?
I'm gonna run now.
Say no!
Come on, you stupid cucks! Fucking
guy! You might be one of the whore!
Well, we did warn you guys about it being PG-13, so there's our PG-13 for the day. And for it to get stuck on a limb.
Hey, I was wanting to go out on a limb here.
Hey, it's following me. Ew! Before long, if it keeps hitting the concrete, it's gonna have a hole in it and it won't fly. I guess that's what you get with a cheap kite, though.
Yeah, what is, also, another question. What was your favorite kind of kite? And what was its design?
Yeah, favorite kind of kite, what is design? It doesn't matter if you bought it or if you made it.
Yeah, because like I said, one of my first kites was one that I made out of twigs and tissue paper.
I actually have never had the experience of making a kite. I've always bought kites.
That's another reason why I can't fly. String's not centered anymore.
Yep.
Here, hold this.
Okay.
First off, there's another tangle because it's all twisted. Sick and twisted.
Like you?
Like who?
Like you.
Like who?
Like you.
Like who?
You remind me of the babe.
What babe?
Babe with the power. And let's not go any further right there or we get copyrighted. And he's continuing it.
Who's asking a question?
By the way, rest in peace, David Bowie. You were the great Goblin King.
You were the only Goblin King.
Yeah. Speaking of which, guys, there is something trending on Facebook right now that Labyrinth is getting a sequel. Although, I've heard it's going to be a sequel, but then I've also heard it's going to be... No, it's not a remake, actually. They said it's either a sequel or more of a prequel. Not a prequel.
Prequel is a sequel.
No, sequel comes after the first movie. Prequel is supposed to take place before the movie. But no, it's not having to do with anything like with the characters from the original Labyrinth. But it is supposed to take place in the world of the Labyrinth. So, but... Yeah, I'm part of this Labyrinth fan group on... Facebook, and just about every day there's been a post about
Hold
on, time check 6:46, but there's been posts about this sequel, and apparently people are getting pissed off about it because the fact that, oh, why didn't they make a sequel while David Bowie was still alive? I refuse to watch the new movie because it's not going to have David Bowie in it and stuff like that. And I was like, I'm watching all these people and it seems like they're being completely prejudiced just because of one actor that was in a movie. Yes, David Bowie was a great actor. He was a great singer. I am a big fan of David Bowie. But the thing is, you can't base the success on a movie just because of one actor. You don't need to like a movie just because of an actor being in it. In my opinion, Yes, you can like the actors that are in a movie, but you like the movie for the story, for the beauty of the movie, how it's filmed, and stuff like that. That was not needed in the middle of my discussion, but...
I don't care.
Well, then again, look who I'm talking to. But... Yeah, because I'm sitting here, like, watching all these people, like, oh my god, Bowie's not in it, so it's going to suck. Bowie's not in it. Like, they should have made this while Bowie was alive. And I'm like, actually, they were thinking about making a sequel while David Bowie was still alive. They just never got around to making it. But, like I said, you shouldn't like a movie just for one specific actor. You should like it because it's got a good plot line, because... of the filmography, the beauty of the backdrops, and the musical score, and stuff like that. Don't just say a movie's automatically gonna bomb because one specific actor isn't in it. Especially when the plot line is probably not even going to involve the character that the actor portrayed to begin with. Am I right?
Yeah. Most of the time, if it's about the Labyrinth, it's about the story of how the Labyrinth got started.
Well, I mean, that could
have... Why is it there? Why has nobody found it?
Well, it could also be, like, before Jareth took over. It could be, like, the beginnings of the Labyrinth before Bowie
still,
took over.
Even so, at the end of the movie, it would at least have... him standing there, standing, possibly as the old Goblin King is dying. Either way, before Jareth, it would have had been like his father or something. It's like...
Well, then we don't know if Jareth also was the successor, or if he took over the Goblin Kingdom, or if he saved the goblins from strife or something. We don't know the backstory.
Actually, I think it was because he saved them that he became the Goblin.
I don't remember anything about that in the movie, so, I mean, there's a bunch of possibilities as to what this new sequel or whatever movie can be about. Okay, and then there's also, there was a four book manga series that also took place after the movie, where Jareth chose Toby as his successor. So, I mean, it could be when Toby took over. So, that could be the sequel that happens. We don't know. But, you don't need to base it just because Bowie's not going to be in there. Especially because, from what I've heard, Jareth's not even supposed to be in the movie in the first place. So, you don't say it's going to suck because Bowie's not in it. If his character's not even involved in the first place.
You got to admit, Bowie and his bulge.
Oh, the infamous Bowie bulge. Yes.
I mean, just about every movie, if not every movie, you can see his bulge at least once.
Well, actually, in The Hunger, you couldn't. The Hunger was actually a pretty good movie. Speaking
Never
of which...
It.
Huh?
Never seen it.
Well, you need to see that then. I've actually got the DVD. No, speaking of The Hunger, another good David Bowie film, but... they gave Bowie top billing, yet his character goes out about halfway through the movie.
Well,
I'm not going to say anything more about it since Death hasn't seen it, so...
Neither are some of them, I bet.
Yeah, and I'm pretty sure you guys haven't seen it either, so no spoiler. But yes, it's supposed to star Susan Sarandon, I can't remember the lead female, and is also supposed to have David Bowie. But...
How many subscribers are we up to already?
Huh?
How many subscribers are we up to already?
Don't think we have that many subscribers yet. Guys, please, look us up. Subscribe to us.
And we would like to thank at least the two. I think there was at least two viewers.
Yes, two viewers commented on our last video. If you're
like
watching this time.
Thank you for
commenting.
Viewing it, commenting on it. And
yes.
Please, like we said, give us more info on what like you guys would want to...
to
see or would want us to possibly try to do.
Yes, we're
like
actually...
Like we said, I do some impressions. I can possibly try to see who all I can do?
Or if you give him an example, he can look it up and see if he can do it, like we said in the last couple of videos. But yes, again, thank you to the two people that commented on the last video and that viewed it. We really appreciate that. If you guys could spread the word around, that way more people can see it.
That's if you guys continue watching us.
Yes, if you guys continue watching us. If you get bored with us, then give us some ideas. That way we can
we don't want to just sit here and constantly ramble about stuff that you guys aren't even interested in.
Yeah, and then we don't want to repeat every episode or every video that, oh yeah, we can do this, we can do this, we can do this. It's like, because it seems like at least that's like the third time we've actually mentioned that you can do the impressions, and that's going to get old after a while.
Yeah, I
so.
Know. And some of you might be thinking, well, quit asking and then just do them. And we'll see.
One of our ideas that we posed in the last video is going around to possible haunted locations and stuff like that. We are actually still looking for places like that around our area, so that'll take a bit. There's actually, I know, one supposed haunted location close by to us, but since it's in the middle of a state park and they close at 10, I don't know. Then again, it is a thoroughfare to another town, so we might could still go there and check it out.
Yeah, and we might exclude the name
Of
that said park, since she had just said that, hey, it's close by us.
Yeah, it is close by us. I mean, well, at least people that are across the U.S. aren't going to know unless they've actually been here, but locals will know.
Some of our viewers aren't locals.
That's true, we don't. So, but yeah, we'll exclude the name of it so we kind of don't get in trouble. Also, I had another idea that would be a good idea for, like, a 24-hour challenge, which I've actually been watching. Yeah, I've actually been watching another YouTuber lately. His name is Aldo's World. It's Aldo's World TV. Shout out to them. Go check them out when you get a chance. Okay, yeah, go check them out when they get a chance. Do a lot of 24-hour challenges. A really good YouTuber. So,
We're not sponsoring.
This is a favorite YouTuber that I've just come across, and I've been watching a lot of his videos. And, yeah, they do a lot of stunts, which should not be done, and 24-hour challenges that they should not be doing in places, but they make for really interesting videos. Now, the place that I'm thinking of that is supposedly haunted, there might be a way to do a 24-hour challenge there, but since it's not that busy of a fairway or thoroughway or whatever the word is, but yeah, I mean, we can do that. Like I said, we're also looking for other places that we can go and possibly do a little ghost hunting for you guys. Whoopsie, I dropped that. But
whoops-tee.
But yeah, that's just some like idea of something we can do. It's like we both like the paranormal, and
hey, maybe if any of you guys possibly work for some small named companies that is selling items, maybe possibly once our channel gets bigger, you guys can possibly start talking about it and be our sponsors.
Yeah, maybe.
I mean, not only that, but if you guys were able to sponsor us, maybe we could eventually get
some way
to possibly reach out and meet you guys.
Yeah. Heck yeah, I mean, even if you're in our local area, or if you're, even if you're across the U.S. and you want to meet up with us, you can. We're probably going to start going to cons when we get more money. So you guys could probably meet up with us at a con too.
Exactly.
You never know. So.
And like we said, we're not one of those people who is going to act all famous and then tell you like piss off or something. No.
Yeah.
If you come try to talk to us, we're going to try to be as nice as we can, get to know you, hang out.
Yeah, we like talking with people. We like getting to know people and stuff like that. It's so yeah, if you guys see us in public or something, come up and talk to us. We'll be happy to chat with you guys.
And sorry, our videos haven't been a daily vlog, like doing it every single day, posting it up. Right now we are still kind of in the middle of some things and trying to get them situated before we can actually
do a day-to-day thing.
Yeah, and be able to reach out to you guys more, give you guys more videos. And somebody got pulled over. Screw you, pigs. What?
What?
I hate pigs.
What if some police officers are watching this?
Everybody's allowed to have their own opinion, right? Not only that, I've met some cops that said, yeah, I hate pigs too. I mean, yes, I am
that's
one, but...
That's surprising.
I've actually had some pigs say, yeah, sometimes you get those ones that, yeah, you have to say, damn pigs.
Huh.
And I don't like how close that guy is driving to the edge.
I have actually...
Or swerving.
Yeah. Guys, again, be safe on the road. Keep an eye on the road. Stay on your side. And don't drive drunk or under the influence of anything because, yeah.
Or talk on your goddamn cell phone. I'm sorry for the yelling, but I hate those type of
motherfuckers. Is that as bad as us vlogging while you're driving?
Well, let's see. I'm not distracted. Yes, I'm talking, but I'm not constantly looking over there. I don't have anything taking away my attention. Because since I'm more focused on the road, not worried about having something on my ear and then shaking my head and shit and going like this and looking away from the road. Not only that, it's because I have both hands free that I can have on the steering wheel in case of emergency.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
And that way I am alert.
That's true. Good point.
Yeah, because he gets in an accident, he's got to quickly try to drop his phone. Grab that steering wheel in order to try it out.
Which sometimes, depending on how quick it is, your reaction time is not the best if you are distracted or have something on your phone, something in your hand that prohibits you from keeping both hands on the steering wheel and stuff like that. So that really slows down your reaction time, which could make an accident worse.
That's basically the same reason why people say don't even eat while driving. Yes, if you can drive with one hand, that's fine, all good and dandy, but...
Sometimes even they say don't do that because, again, reaction time. If you take that sudden sip of a drink, then, oh my god, accident. So, there's something that always happens in a split second. And you just need to be really safe.
Yeah.
When you're on the road. Don't let anything distract you.
I mean, yes, me, I'm no damn saint. I mean, I do love to speed every now and then, like now, because I'm on 70 and a 55. But yeah, basically, don't do anything stupid. Don't try to get caught. Don't get caught. Just basically, don't do it.
Just don't do anything wrong to begin with, and you'll be fine.
So we keep on going on spiels like this, but assholes need to be warned.
Yeah.
Technically, they shouldn't need a fucking warning, but come on.
I would rather somebody just tell me calmly than use those scare tactic commercials that they use on TV.
Oh, but scaring people is much more fun.
I hate those commercials. Oh my god, no. There's a couple of other YouTubers I've been watching. I can't remember the names right now. But they put out these compilations of so many scary PSAs. Like drunk driving PSAs, child abuse PSAs, just to name a few. And it was like, I hate those. Like, especially those that involve a child getting hurt or something. I hate those. Some of them make me cry more than scare me. And it was,
because they consider you crying as you being scared.
Yeah.
Because you don't want that to happen.
Yeah, exactly. But it's like, I get more sad than scared. And I was like, I do not like those commercials.
Yeah.
And it's like, I'd rather just have somebody tell me. But then again, some of people are hard-headed and they need to be scared.
Like
to
some
get
of those kids
across.
Who go on into the Scared Straight program get thrown in prison with those adults.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, personally, I would love to do that. I would love to have somebody throw me in there with a bunch of adults trying to scare the shit out of me.
And then you not be scared and then wonder, what the hell, dude? Why aren't you scared of us? Because I'm just crazy and screwed up as you guys are.
I'm not dumb enough to get caught. And you are. Wait, what?
Wow.
What? What?
Do we need to keep an eye on you?
Oh, maybe. I don't know.
By the way, sorry for the glare. Just the sun is like right over there. Yeah, but since you drive, it is the best way I can get both of us in the shot. But I'm trying to film in the top. Oh yeah, another idea was tearing movies apart. We already did that with this Labyrinth sequel somewhat earlier, at least discussing the topic of that. I still want to get my rant out about another TV show.
At least say the name of it.
Yes, Lion Guard.
Oh, God. So many flaws.
I have given death this spiel I don't know how many times. But, no, I am a Lion King fan. Yes, I am talking about a kids' cartoon show on Disney Junior. But the fact that I am a Lion King fan, if any of you guys have seen Lion King 2, you know that, of course, Simba and Nala had a daughter.
Spoilers.
Spoilers if you haven't seen it, but it's been around so long, who hasn't seen it except for little kids. But, yeah, Simba and Nala have a daughter. She's all being the rebel. I don't want to be queen, blah, blah, blah. It's like, I don't want to take my place in the Pride Land as the next queen. I want to have fun and be my own person and stuff like that. Then, so many years later, however many years later that Lion Guard come out, Simba and Nala suddenly have a son that is not too much younger than Kiara, never mentioned in the Lion King canon at all, and he's the leader of the Lion Guard. It's like, okay, first of all, Disney, if we're going to start introducing characters, you need to have some kind of throwback to the other series. Like, you should have at least introduced him in this movie so there's no confusion in the timelines.
And then people going random and raving.
Yeah, like
and
me.
Pitching to them in emails.
Yeah,
I've actually known some people who got so pissed off at them, they kept on constantly saying, you know what, I am a famous YouTuber, or I'm this, I know a lot of people, we are going to boycott your movies and stuff from now on because you're going to lose all this money unless you make up a new freaking movie.
Well, I'm not.
To be like a little jump thing, like, so that you can't introduce these characters.
Yeah, because the point is like, as in Lion King 2, you see Kiara, the daughter, grow up and become an adult. Yet, Kion, the little brother, is nowhere to be seen. Then you come out with Lion Guard, and he's there, and they totally changed Kiara's personality to, oh my god, yeah, now I want to be queen. I want to make my parents proud and be queen and use it to my advantage and rule over my little brother so I can boss him around.
Yeah,
and I'm like, no, that is not Kiara's personality that you have already established in the movie.
Exactly. Not only that, but what are they gonna do? Just come out and say, forgot to mention, he's adopted.
Or something like that. I was like, I doubt he's adopted. But it was like, unless it's like one of the other lionesses' kids. But of course, Disney, you're not gonna say that and go realistic. But Yeah, that's just like, okay, don't get me wrong. I do like Lion Guard because it is a cute little TV show, and my three-year-old loves it. I will actually sit down and watch it with her because I'm such a Lion King fan. But that is the pet peeve because I am such a Lion King fan. And I also actually saw an episode not too long ago where the show actually showed Kovu, his brother Nuka, and his sister Vatani from Lion King 2. And they mentioned that, oh yeah, we know Kiara. Or Kovu says, oh yeah, I've met Kiara before. And I'm like, okay, so you did do the a little bit of a throwback to number 2, but you've still got Kion that was never mentioned in the second movie. And it's just a completely new character that you introduced just for this series. And it's like, storyline, please? Yeah. Where did this come from? Where did he come from? Why wasn't he in Lion King 2 when you saw Nala growing up?
Yeah, and not
I mean,
only
Kiara
that,
growing up?
Not only that, another thing that really pisses me off about Disney is that Disney loves orphaning children and give them these damn big ass storylines. Why don't they ever make it to where that those orphans eventually grow up and adopting their own children or children of their own, adopting some children? No.
Are you talking about the motherless kids?
Well, let's see. Like you said, Simba. Simba became an orphan because his father was killed.
But he had his mother.
He never really seen much of her mother. So basically orphaning him.
But he was fostered by Timon and Pumbaa.
Exactly.
And was able to reunite with his mother later on in adulthood.
Exactly, because they basically orphan him just to make it where there's Timon and Pumbaa. Come on, again, that's still saying, well, he's at a young age, he's an orphan, he's young, he's orphaned, does not know his mother that much anymore. After going through all these years of not having a mother, and then finally rekindling, having him rekindle his relationship with his mother, come on, you still make him, he's still an orphan, who just rekindles with his long-lost parent.
Well, you know where they got the basis for Lion King, right? Part of it was based on Shakespeare's Hamlet. Part of it was based on the biblical story of Moses. That there was some other, like, plots in it. Well, the Hamlet part comes from the uncle killing the father and banishing Simba. Because that's what Hamlet's uncle did to Hamlet. He killed his father. The uncle killed his father and then banished Hamlet. So that's where that comes in.
That also started the same thing of Romeo and Juliet.
No, that's a completely different story. But, and then the Moses aspect comes in of the grow up in exile, come back to save his people from the evil tyrant kind of thing. That's where the biblical story of Moses comes in. So those were the two big basis for the movie, for the Lion King movie.
Oh, and also, by the way, another thing that just popped into my head, random as usual. Another thing that we were possibly thinking, we tried once, but had some complications of a debate. Like debating on this and or between this.
Yeah, we
it's
actually...
It's like the one that we're talking about we tried before, had some complications for, was like, which is better, cats or dogs? Me, as a wolf, I prefer dogs.
Yeah, we did try doing that debate with one of our other friends, but the program I was using kind of screwed up, and we didn't have sound. For some reason, I had sound at first, but then when I tried to start recording, somehow it ended up turning off that setting.
That's OBS.
So,
it's
OBS Studio. It's OBS Studio. Other YouTubers or anybody's ever worked with that. Yeah, I checked it right before we started recording, but then as soon as I record, I go back after the recording and then try to re-listen to it or re-watch it. And I'm like, where's the sound? What happened to the sound? I go back and look at my settings. Settings for the sound completely turned off.
Yeah, not only that,
I was
maybe,
like, what the heck?
Maybe some of you guys, if you know OBS, can
tell
us
pointers,
like how to do that? Where if you go do a test and then it's like, testing it, making sure the sound and stuff's good. How do we get it to where the sound doesn't automatically turn off next time you start recording?
Yeah, because that's what we did. We tested it. It did fine. Then when I went to actually do the regular recording, the sound turned off. Or the setting turned off. And it's like, well, it was fine just a minute ago. What the heck happened? So, yeah, still learning how to use it. That's also, too, if you guys have another
recording software program
that right now is free that we can actually use to record stuff like that, record off a screen, like
off
computer,
a PC,
off a PC
something.
And stuff like that. If you guys know some kind of software that's good, that is free, can you please let us know down in the comments? That way.
I'm heading to Ogre's.
Okay. Yeah. Just that way we can know if there's anything better than OBS out there. Because like we said, soon in the future we do want to start doing streaming and stuff like that.
Like,
but if
to
we
play
can,
video games and stuff and like that, and try out new things.
Yeah, but if we can, then we can also
video reactions, or
like I said, even. Just recording off of the screen itself, because like I said, our Death and I got into a Skype conversation with one of our friends to do that debate. It's like we want to do stuff like that as well. And hey, even like later on when we get more popular, get more viewers and stuff, we might call you, we might let y'all, allow y'all into a Skype conversation and do live Q&A's or something. So something for the future.
Yeah, not only that, but if we do eventually do that and the subject gets like way off topic, we most likely then that will ruin it for other people that might want to be able to actually have questions and actual things that they would want to talk to a person about. It's like, not only that, sometimes we might want to get to know you beforehand. So we might want to get to know you, like, PM you before actually, like, think of, like, calling some of you guys and having you in a vid with us.
Hey, yeah, you know, we might even just do random Q&A videos where you guys can post out the questions down in the comments of a previous video, and then the next video come out and do a Q&A. Which we will let you know before we do that too.
Yeah.
So.
I mean, in other words, as of right now, what you can do is possibly like
start us off with some questions.
Put some questions down below. We can jot those. We can write those down. Write those down for some possible future videos. So that way we can have some questions already prepared, ready, and so. And don't. And as we say with like some of the dare challenges, don't get it too personal.
Don't do too personal. Don't do too raunchy or racy.
Yeah. Because those, then we're just going to have to try to ignore it. And if you constantly do that, we might even just have to say, you know what? You do this one more time, you're gone. And we're going to have to ban you. It's like,
really ban on YouTube?
You can, in a way, ban, but it's just.
It'd be more of a block thing, I think. Or,
yeah,
we're just gonna not allow.
Not only that, if you start doing that, then you're just gonna ruin it for other people to where they can't do that.
And yeah.
Just like at where I'm staying, somebody ended up stealing my phone. And then the person who, I was charging it on a friend's, like, outlet, like a little extension cord box thing, whatever you want to call it. And his ended up coming missing because we thought somebody had stole it. And so he ended up taking the plug away, saying, you know what, that's it. Nobody's going to be able to charge your stuff over here anymore. And so, right now, please don't ever do anything that's going to ruin it for somebody else.
Yeah.
Because some of those other people might have actual good questions that you guys may want to know and never and possibly would never have thought of.
Yeah, because if it gets to that point, then we might just end the Q&As altogether, just so we don't get those questions. If there's no way to actually ban, then the Q&As will just go away.
Yeah, because like we said, no religious questions.
No political.
No political. And it's just like stuff like that that you know for a fact is going to start a war within the comments or with us versus you. No, don't.
Yeah, because if there's a video that the comments start getting too bad and you'll start bullying each other in the comments or whatever, we will disable comments on the videos.
Yes, because at this point, we... missed my turn. But at this point, guys, we do not want to get... you guys, we don't want to ruin it for anything. As of right now, and for always, we are going to be a bully-free channel. Because we can't... some of us have been bullied all our lives and stuff, and is sick and tired of all the bullies. I mean, me, I was bullied so damn much, I had to become a bully, thus in myself, in order to try to get those people to stop.
See, bullying transfers to other people, which is not a good thing. And apparently, most people don't count social network bullying as cyberbullying, which it is.
Yes, because some of the state's law is says any social media as is against the law. As cyberbullying on any social media technically is against the law. But in some states, I guess they have this little code type thing that's saying, oh, Facebook ain't social media. Facebook doesn't count.
Yes.
Basically, in other words, what you're saying is people can bully online because all that stuff is a social media that people are going to get on. What the judge has told some people, judges have told some people that if you're being bullied, then just get off of it. Yeah. Quit doing it.
But it is a criminal offense, which, I mean, there's even FBI teams out there trying to stop bullying because it is a criminal offense. I even had an incident where somebody was cyberbullying me on Facebook, slandering me, and stuff like that. I tried to go get a temporary protection order on the person. Judge says, oh, social media doesn't count as cyberbullying.
No, Facebook.
Or Facebook.
He said social
yeah,
media.
Facebook does not count as cyberbullying. Dad actually had the bright idea to look up the law, state law. And it said for cyberbullying,
all social media,
which is Facebook included, since Facebook is social media.
Yeah,
I show it to the judge, and he's still trying to swear straight up and down.
He gets pissed off all the hell because I caught him when he was wrong. He's like, oh, but I'm just following the fucking code of what I was told.
But
I was told to do it this way.
But
this
is state law. I mean, he's like, oh, don't quote the state law to me. And I was like, then you should know it is cyberbullying in this state is a criminal offense. And he just got all pissed off. And there were other people in the room when we were trying to get him to sign it. And finally, he just said, okay, fine, because he didn't want to look wrong in front of the other people.
Stole my spot because people wouldn't get out of my way.
But it's like, yeah, just don't cyberbully altogether. It's not right. Because it is still a form of bullying.
Might have to park a distance.
It can lead to suicide, which is not a good thing.
Yeah,
any form of bullying, whether it's cyber, physical, verbal, anything could take a dark turn, and that is something we don't need.
Yeah, because I was bullied so much that I've actually contemplated suicide, even tried to commit suicide. I mean, yes, it was one of the dark moments in my life, but that I tried to commit suicide. Because somebody kept bullying me so bad that they just pushed me to it to where I had to say, you know what, fuck this shit. I'm constantly getting bullied. Nobody likes me, so might as well say fuck my life.
Oh my god, and I like the car we just parked beside because it had decals of Sailor Moon, the TARDIS.
And they got a hanging
Batman. It is like all the fandoms, X-Files.
We're going to have to pause it, if not cut it here, and until we can possibly come back, because we got to go in and shop with some things and get ready. So if we don't talk, if you don't talk to us later, you might see this, you might not see this, but either ways, see you guys for now.
Well, I haven't seen you guys. This has been Serenity's Inmere.
And Death 109F.
For Serenity's Death, and we'll see you guys later.
And remember, stay evil.